It's been interesting to be able to watch something be introduced to my field of sculpture that changes it radically. I liken 3D printing to when Photoshop was introduced to photography, and Illustrator to design work, you know, when everything went onto the computer. Well, sculpture hadn't been on the computer. What it's done to sculpture has been unbelievably fast, so we're all adapting quickly. I'm Kimberly Callis. I am a figurative sculptor and social practice artist. We're at Monmouth University in the sculpture studio. I'm an academically trained figurative sculptor, a very old tradition. I sculpt in clay from models often, and then I'll cast the work, so either in bronze or concrete. What's really great about the Gigabot is that I like to work life size, and so on a smaller 3D printer, I wouldn't be able to create the large sculptures that I like to do. My work comes out of my work in sustainability. I realized people were having a hard time responding to just environmental data, but if it were a stream or something that they fished in as a child, then they would really protect that space. And so I wanted to find those more emotional connections in people. It built into a project that mostly focuses on an ecological self, how we're part of nature. The mask series started as an idea around the ecological self, and I call them eco-portraits. Doing a specific portrait of an individual around a symbol or image or pattern from nature that's significant to that person. Where is that intimate link between them and nature? Before, I would sculpt from a model to get the portrait, and then I would sculpt and dig into the clay the different patterns. The way that the 3D printing has helped it is now I could take a scan of my model and I can 3D print their head, and then I sculpt from the head. I still work in the clay, but I'll be working from a 3D print of the model, so they don't have to sit there that long. And then the other thing that's been a huge advantage is often when I want to get an intricate pattern into the clay, and then I make the mold and then I cast it, some of that pattern gets disturbed and broken or needs to be repaired. There's a lot of repair work. With a 3D print, I scan in my sculpture, I can digitally go in and get a pattern without much repair work, and I can just 3D print it rather than cast it. I work back and forth between the digital and the handmade the whole time. There's a couple of different things that are really important. One is that you can change things really quickly, and so if you're working digitally and you need to shrink something down or enlarge it, 3D printing is much faster than working in clay. I mean, there's no comparison, it's so much quicker. I can just do the undo button, but if I don't like something in clay, I have to rebuild it. If you have to make a mold of a sculpture, it takes you quite a long time, but I can scan a sculpture in a couple minutes, and then I can 3D print it very quickly compared to what it takes to cast from a mold. I'm looking forward to emailing my file to the foundry rather than shipping huge molds or carrying them to a foundry. Those are some really big advantages. I'm working towards 3D printing a full figure that has these patterns from nature right in it, almost like tattooed into the skin, and I'm looking at them as being figures that represent that embodied in place, and how place very literally becomes part of us through what we eat, through what we breathe. And then now I'm doing test prints for the life-size figure, so the Gigabot's been perfect for that. The whole body should take about 10 to 12 prints, and I expect that the print time is going to be about 1,300 hours.